In sorority life, everyone gets a big sister, but like not everyone gets a little sister. And I never thought I would, just because of grades and other things. But on March 3rd, 2013, aww, I got to get a little sister, and it was Taylor. And I'm gonna cry because you're videotaping me. See, I didn't know Taylor before. I'd never met her before. I think I maybe said like a couple words to her. But I wanted to make her feel welcome, because I was always, you know, let her know I was always there if she ever needed anything. But when I was told she would be my little sister, I was a little confused, because I didn't know her. But I quickly learned about her with the assistance of my best friend, because they both went to high school together. And on March 3rd, I didn't know I was going to meet one of my best friends. I'm sorry, I'm a mess. From seeing Aaron Carter together in concert and seeing One Direction on the floor, you know, to the nights that we spent in the Faisal house just shooting the breeze with everyone. To the numerous trips to Starbucks, because yes, I know her order by heart and I know what makes her happy.
Amen.
To cook, you know, chilling and cook with the underground pizza being called because we knew it was going to be a late night. The girl who was always down to bring me OEC because she knew what I really needed. Taylor lived by our sorority's motto, which was we live for each other. Taylor always lived for me, even when I left for 7 months to go work in Disney. And I knew I could call her and just release from some of the frustrations I was having, because she always knew what to say. I miss you, Beak. And Taylor always lived for me, even after she left Southern Miss to pursue her dream in nursing. And when she doubted herself, I always made sure that she thought of every option and remembered that she was going into nursing and why. When she had troubles with her previous relationships, I made sure that I could be there for her and be a listening ear and when she needed it. And man, we've been through a lot of mistakes. We all saw Taylor through a lot of ups and downs, but it was so comforting to know when she found Tyler. She found someone to love her no matter what, and that would move around the country with her, raise 4 crazy dogs with her, and someone that wanted to spend the rest of her life with her and treat her like a queen, and still does. Aww. Tyler, I still got a lot of learning about you. I just met you. But I know you're the right man for her. I'm excited to see you your journey together, and I will always be there if you ever need me. I'm always just a phone call away. I love you both. I'm so excited to see y'all walk down the aisle tomorrow. And Tyler, I've got a little bit of advice for you. 2 things. First, the best answer to give Taylor is yes, dear. I'll get you very far in life. Very far. The other thing is to share your goddamn cheese dip.
Yes!
Don't be nervous.
I was getting nervous.
I just like memory.
I will.
Hi all, thank you for coming to Taylor's rehearsal dinner. I'm Jonathan. I haven't met most of you, actually, except for Jasmine. But likewise, I met Taylor in college, and it was a happenstance meeting. I met her through a friend, and I don't think we knew how close we were gonna become over the years. We had some crazy moments, crazy experiences that you really don't talk about at wedding rehearsal dinners. We did. She could probably tell you at another time, but we had countless times where we would just hang out in my apartment. We'd talk about life and the struggles and not really knowing where we were going. I met her prior to her actually deciding to be a nurse. We were both in the theater program. We both thought we were going to do great things on stage and go on to become stars of the world. And little did we know we were going to, just in a different way. We lost contact after that. We didn't get really close until about 2 years ago, but we've always had that strand of friendship that's never going to snap. And over the last 2 years, we've really been able to see each other warp and move towards success. And just watching her grow as a human being has been really inspirational. It's the one word I can use to sum up Taylor is inspirational. She inspires everybody she meets to be better and to do better and to just be the best person they can be. It's funny that she's a nurse, because I've never used the word infectious as an adjective to describe somebody, but she is. She's got this positivity and this light and this energy that she just gives to everybody around her. I don't think I've met a person that has come into contact with Taylor and not left a better human being and not left with just a little bit of her light. I know that every day I look forward to your calls, because we do call daily. Be jealous. I look forward to it. I've never been more productive than I'm talking to Taylor, and I've never been more enlightened and more happy to be alive than when I talk to her. Whether it's a bad day, a good day, Taylor makes it better. And I know that over this past year, moving towards the marriage, we've been evolving our talks and talking more and more about what her life's going to be like after she gets married, what she's looking forward to, what she's nervous about. We talk about our gripes. We talk about the things that go well. If anybody knows what's going on with my marriage, it's going to be Taylor. And if anything, I know what's going on with theirs. And so going into meeting Tyler, I was a little nervous because we are each other's scratching post. We do like to talk about what makes us anxious in our marriages. And Tyler, I just want to say that everything she's told me about you has been accurate. Like, I didn't really know what I was going to do meeting you. Yeah, no, not bad things. Everything's been accurate. She, meeting you last night for the first time, I also just met Tyler for the first time. I can see what she sees, and I can see why she's so happy to start her journey with you. The charisma, the humor, the support, I see it. I see the little movements you do, the small touches, the small looks, and I just see the love that you pour out to her every time you look her in the face. And I also see it from her side, too. So I know that y'all are going to go forward into a happy, happy relationship. And also, I do have to touch on Disney also, because we do have that insane love of Disney. So my advice to you is to always say yes to a Disney trip, never shoot it down, and always have Starbucks ready, because Taylor does love her Starbucks.
Yes, she does.
Yes, she does. So I wish y'all the happiest marriage, and I know it's going to be amazing.
Aww. I'm going to my best.
Did you want him as your best
friend? Yeah, he was so sweet.
The little sister. Also the favorite. This is my first wedding, so, you know, I'm glad it's hers. Growing up, we weren't close.
Aww.
It's okay!
We didn't do much together, and because of our age difference, but I grew to be a mini you, and you taught me well. You're such a bright, intelligent person. I'm so inspired by you. I'm so happy to see you get married and walk down the aisle. The big day has come, and I'm so happy to be a part of it. I love you. Tyler. We're alike by a lot, so I know Taylor can put up with you. I'm glad you're the one for her, and she's the one for you. She deserves the best, and I'm glad she's found it. Thank you for making her happy and treating her well. I love y'all.
I love you too,
Oh.
I recorded this.
You guys didn't know Bailey doesn't get emotional ever. Ever.
Thank you.
think so. Oh, so we run. I love you so much. Look, you wore your ring. What do you think?
That's amazing. Oh, just gorgeous.
It looks good, huh?
Beautiful. Oh.
I love it. Thanks.
Good, the spin.
She doesn't have a really long one, so. Hold on a minute, I got a picture for this. Hi. There we go.
Wait 1 second. Do you like it? Oh, I missed you. Sorry we're late.
I know it's coming, but you're so sorry.
But did you anticipate it being this late?
Yes, I did.
Yep. It's not a hat. You look nice too. I love your bow tie. Yeah.
Thank you, Dustin.
You're just so nice. Yeah.